wondering if you were going to be bringing out your passions of the cooking and singing into the librarians like you did on The Leverage.
There was an episode where they were talking about me singing, but I decided, I know you're going to get mad, but I decided not to just because of the tone of that show. It was more, you know, when I did Angel, when I sang on Angel, it was celebrated. You know, it was a thing with beautiful Andy Hallett. And, you know, I don't know if you noticed, but that, like, I was going to stay on and not be gone those two seasons. They tried to cut a deal, but I had gotten another job playing Angelina Jolie's fiance, so you got to do what you got to do. So, listen. but the thing was, as I sang, it was supposed to be like a, when me and Charisma Carpenter, it was supposed to be like a love interest that was developing. You can kind of see it right there. It kind of fell apart because I had to go. But that was celebrated. And then on Leverage, I feel like it was celebrated. And on this one, I didn't feel like it was being celebrated. And I didn't think it, honestly, I didn't think it was fair to you guys, to be honest with you. That's what I told my boss. I said, I'd rather not do it because I don't think it's fair to them. You know, because they've always done it in such a great light. So, I mean, I do, we sing a little bit but this year, but it's more, it's in the first episode, it's in the season 3 opener. But it's more funny and comedy than anything else. But the cooking thing, I mean, they dealt with it just a minute. I keep trying to bring the damn chupacabra back. Just start the show with me in this like basement making jerky and just like have this furry thing run by. I joke about it all the time with Chris. I'm like, where's Jacob? I'm like, he's down with the chief coppers. and there's a thing this year with Flynn that I tell him, thank God you don't remind me not to let you into the annex kitchen. So I feel like you'll see this year that I don't really cook on the show, but you feel like the stone's down the cooker.
Thank you.
Yeah. So you've worked with some absolutely amazing actors. Who's still on your bucket list that you
can
work with?
Oh man, you know, I mean, I knocked out Robert Duvall and Michael Caine in one shot. If I could have one person that I'd really want to work with, and like, I mean extensively, not just coming in, it would probably be Anthony Hopkins. And then, I mean, I can watch this guy do anything. I'm such a huge fan of Paul Giamatti. I just can watch him do the phone book, you know what I mean? He's so talented. So, I mean, I sure would love to work with Paul one day. But there's still a bunch of people out there, and I still get, you know, it's a... I think Anthony Hopkins would have to be another one.
Oh.
You know, and there's so many people that I haven't got here. De Niro, Pacino, you know, all those guys. Dustin Hoffman, for Christ's sake. But I think Anthony Hopkins would be my number one. If I could work with anybody, I'd like to work with him.
So related to that, at this point in your career, who do you geek out over? Who makes you just go, oh my God, that's so-and-so, to even meet them?
Ralph Macchio.
Me and Matt, I was in the elevator. I was just like, what's going on? I know, man. And he's such a nice guy. I don't know, I highly recommend taking a picture of talking to him because he's such a nice guy. I mean, he is Danny LaRusso. But that was pretty great. And then, I mean, I've geeked out a couple times with some people that I've met in life. I mean, I hate to say it right now because of everything that's going on with them. But when I first got to Los Angeles, I was walking, I was making deliveries, I wasn't even an actor yet, and I bumped into Bill Cosby. And I remember just kind of, you know, being a fan. He was nice, he wasn't overly nice, but he was nice. But at that time, screw what's happening right now. I mean, he's gonna have to deal with that. And he's gonna have to deal with that in the afterlife too. But he was, you know, my dad worked, we all worked. I got home, the Cosby Show raised me. You know, that's where I found my morals and my values was through that show. You know, so to meet him, he was kind of bad to me at the time. You know, I really don't appreciate what he's done. But anyways, that was one time I remember, and then I met Elton John one time. It was pretty cool. That was pretty cool to get to meet Elton. It was only for a brief moment. It was pretty fun. I think I told that story before. It was for an Andre Agassi benefit, and he had just openly come out. probably weeks ago, and he said, and he got on stage and he said, you know, John, you know, Andre, I wanted to come up here and tell you that, you know, with this charity thing, I'm right behind you, but that may not be the best thing to do. So. I thought it was great. He's so he's talented. Bernie Taupin wrote his songs, but so I'm a fan of Bernie's as well. But I listen to him, John.
First part of next year, you'll be back in the studios, hopefully, cutting a new album. Or that was your intent?
I'm so sorry.
She thinks you'll be. She heard that you'll be in the studio next year, cutting a new album.
Yeah,
that was your intent.
It is. I mean, we were working 15 hours this year. My intent was to get all the songs together while I was doing the Librarians, but I actually did not have one day off. It was even the rest of the cast was going, Jesus, you're here, you know. And so I didn't get to put the songs together, but I hopefully will get to put the songs together. Me and Hank are working on some stuff right now, and hopefully by the end of the year I'll have pretty much an idea of what's going to happen. Yeah,
we're waiting impatiently.
And I feel really bad. It's just like, you know, Eric just told me the other day that Let Me Go, the video for that was released 5 years ago. Mm-hmm. So I just want him to be right, and I want him to be good, you know. And I don't play with Steve anymore, and I really don't have a band, and so it's really hard when I get an idea to be able to really have it out there. And I've been working so much that I haven't been able to get back to Nashville for some of the cats that I write with there. But that's all coming. I promise.